All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Paul Edick. He's the CEO of Xeris Biopharma. And Paul, it's good to see you again. How are you?
Very well, Steve. Thank you very much. Good to see you again.
Yeah, we got so much to talk about. You've got financial numbers out, a lot of things happening in 2024. But before we get to that, just let's remind everyone a little bit about the company itself, just so we have that on record for everyone.
Well, we're a multifaceted company. We have three commercial assets, 2023, that we're all growing. We've got our own underlying technologies, building products in our own pipeline, and we're partnering our technologies with a couple of big pharma companies. So very exciting company. We're growing a nice little business.
Yeah, absolutely. And it shows that in your most recent financial numbers as well, fourth quarter and year end. Tell me a little bit about what you saw in the numbers.
Yeah, we had a great 2023. I thought the call was really good. We exceeded our expectations. We finished the year with $164 million in revenue, which is at the high end of our guidance at the beginning of the year, $72 million in cash, which was above our original guidance. We actually were cash positive in the fourth quarter, which was a nice thing to see. The underlying business is in tremendous shape. We still have the partnerships and other stuff going on. So it was really good.
Good stuff. You also did a refinancing, and maybe we could sort of get you to address that as well, and sort of the reasoning behind it and what that allows the company to do now.
Yeah, it's very opportunistic. The structured finance markets are red hot right now, and interest rates are coming down. The facility we had was a floating rate, which got more expensive as interest rates went up. And we had an opportunity that we had a lot of people competing to put a new facility in place. We ended up with Hayfin, which was our original lender, but we ended up with $200 million at the same cost as we were paying for the $150 million. And the savings that we have over the term of the loan basically paid to do the deal. So, and we reduced our total cost of capital by over 200 basis points. So it was the right time, the right place, and a lot of competitors. So we were able to really get a good deal at the end of the day. And it puts a little bit more cash, another $35 million on the balance sheet, so that we can continue to be a self-sustaining business. We don't have to raise money in the capital markets, and we can invest behind our commercial products and our technologies a little bit.
Yeah, and obviously you've released your 2024 guidance, and with what you just talked about, the refinance, that really goes into what the guidance is for this year, because you've set some pretty good numbers.
Yeah, once again, our range in terms of total revenue is pretty wide because there are some uncontrollable factors. In 2023, we weren't too sure what was going to happen with Keveyis, which is one of our drugs that has a generic competitor. That remains a question mark. So our guidance of $170 to $200 million this year is pretty wide, but we expect to do well. And our partner revenue is episodic. So last year we had some partner revenue. We're not sure what's going to happen this year in terms of how fast our partners are going to go. So our range was a little wider, but we also guided to finish the year between 55 and 75 million of cash in the bank. So we'll still burn a little bit, but not enough that we would ever have to raise capital. So it's, I thought our guidance was very positive and, says that we're going to continue to grow our business in 2024.
Absolutely. What else is coming up in 2024, Paul?
Well, in 23, we triggered a CVR, which is a contingent value right for Keveyis. So Strongbridge shareholders are going to get some extra shares, which is a good news for them from the acquisition of Strongbridge. The number of shares that they get was a fixed at the time of the acquisition. I know there have been people doing some math on current prices. There's been some confusion, but it was fixed at the time of the acquisition. There'll be about 7.5 million shares go into the marketplace. And our technology partnerships continue to march along. Amgen continues to move forward. Regeneron continues to move forward. We're in the, what we call the second phase, which is stability with those deals. And, we're anticipating a good 2024.
Yeah. Paul, it seems in just what you're describing in the numbers and the work you've been able to do behind the scenes that you feel very confident in where the company is right now and really where the future lies.
We do. We feel very confident. We saw some drop in the share price after our earnings release, which didn't make any sense at all. Companies in great shape. We're advancing our commercial business. We're building our own pipeline. We've got partnerships. We're talking to more companies about partnerships. Business is in good shape. So we're pretty excited for another great year.
Well, really appreciate your time, Paul. Thanks very much. Look forward to having you back again real soon. And we'll talk then, okay?
Thanks. Really appreciate it.
All right. Paul Edick, the CEO of Xeris Biopharma.